Hi everyone, I'm Ken from CryptoTradingKS. If you're new, welcome, and welcome back, KS family. Let's run the numbers. Bitcoin currently down 2.8% to 42,614. Ethereum down 3.41% to 32,49. From my 30 plus years in financial markets, I explain the smart money mindset to assist you to be more of a financial blessing to yourself and those you love, gaining real wealth in the process. If you would like daily updates on price movements in the crypto market, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, please subscribe to YouTube. I know many members in the community and the general population are going through a life pullback at the moment. Please know that our community's love and healing thoughts are with you. You're not alone. There's always hope, and the sun will come out again. And a special reach out to Cindy, Rocky, and Tommy. All the best, my friends. Turning to the crypto fear and greed index, we can see we're at extreme fear at the moment, and we've been bubbling along there for quite a while. This is the absolute best time for investors to dollar cost average in. But with the retail mindset, most people are actually heading for the door. It's really important to understand Rule 45. No alt can escape Bitcoin's gravity. Zooming in on Bitcoin's price action, we can see Bitcoin currently trading at 42,546. There's a daily resistance line playing out that Bitcoin broke out of yesterday, is coming back into retest. There's a lot of support around this 41,933 mark. What does that basically mean? We're kind of on the side of being partially red, but we're also very close to a turnaround. For example, if Bitcoin can breach the 44,729 level, it starts to get into the I'm not sure where I'm going zone, but it's not a red zone. How red is the red zone? We would expect prices to bottom out around the 37,406 mark if they come down. It's really unlikely that we'll go any further down than that. Over 5 weeks ago, on December the 5th, 2021, I called out the potential likelihood of a specific pattern playing out. We're just seeing that pattern play out now. With this in mind, it is potential that price could come down into this 37,406 level. We never know. We only can actually rely on probabilities. This is a pattern that's played out in the crypto market many, many times. The key to counter uncertainty is to make in advance probabilistic choices. Know what you will do if price comes down. Know what you will do if price goes up, and know what you will do if price goes horizontally. This is really, really important stuff. There's a massive difference between retail thinking and smart money thinking. They're almost polar opposites. When retail investors are heading for the door, smart money thinking is accumulating. It happens all the time, and it actually inverses when prices go up. When we look at the KS model, which is a crypto technical trading model based on institutional smart money price psychology, we're still in the bull market segment of the run. We can see the RSI has come down to really, really low levels. Institutional and smart money investors look at this with great joy because they understand the prices are at bargain basement level. I've put a target on the estimated peak of the bull market cycle at the 25th of May, 2022. But how could that get there? Ted, a member of our community and a masterclass member, has been tracking various different models over time. Ted's been doing an absolutely fantastic job. You can follow him at @tboydsto on Twitter. What we can see is the KS model is this particular line. We can also see that price has been tracking the KS model incredibly well. If price continues to track this model that Ted has basically put together, we can see the target of 486 on the 25th of May, 2022 is still in order. We need and require an exponential blow off top. This is the hallmark of the crypto market. Fidelity Digital Assets put out a really good article, Research Roundup 2021 Trends and Their Potential Future Impact by Chris and Jack. Hi, Chris and Jack. Let's go down. There's a particular section that I want to draw your attention to. Basically, they say, and this is really important to understand, if Bitcoin adoption increases, countries will secure Bitcoin today to make sure that they are competitively better off than their peers. And if they don't do it, well, they'll be forced to acquire. The authors therefore see they wouldn't be surprised to see other sovereign nation states acquire Bitcoin in 2022 and perhaps even see a central bank make an acquisition. Very, very true. There's a really incredibly wide gap between institutional and smart money thinking and retail thinking. There's also the concept that Bitcoin and crypto is just the next level of the internet, and this is missed by a lot of people. As we get adoption of Web 3.0, we're actually going to see cryptos explode, but they also do many other things. Web 3.0, as it applies to crypto, is the internet of value, not the internet of information, the internet of money. With so much uncertainty in the world, and it's always uncertain, Rule 774 becomes really, really important. Master yourself to master the market. I put KS's own analysis together to help people understand the four stages that all investors and traders progress through to become consistently profitable and attain real wealth. Zones 1 and Zones 2, which are about panic and blame, are an addiction to certainty. The certainty trap is a major, major problem for people. People want certainty, but they don't understand certainty is a trap. When you reach out and you demand certainty, you're actually demanding losses. When people enter the market from Zone 1 and Zone 2, they generally gear up to the maximum amount of leverage that they can. After all, they've been promised big returns, so it's easy to make and no knowledge is required. It's kind of just a form of gambling. And the problem with gambling is that gamblers don't last in markets like crypto. Zones 1 and Zones 2 actually breed a problem called perfect timing. Perfect timing is a fantasy. It's like, I'm going to buy the absolute bottom of this, and I'm going to sell the absolute top of this, and whatever I miss out on, I'm going to cry about because I should have got it. I'm certain as to where things are going. This certainty doesn't exist. Also, a lot of people in Zone 1 and Zone 2 seek to capture everything. It's just a natural state of progression that all investors and traders progress through. And this is really important. Every single trader and investor, the best ones in the world, have gone through panic and blame. And it's incredibly important to know that. When people know that, they can forgive themselves. And knowledge and forgiveness are hallmarks of Zone 3, when people actually move into probability, rules, and patience. This is critically important, but if people don't pick up meaning, they can cycle back into panic, blame, and keep on cycling. The meaning zone, the zone that we talk about all the time within our community, is the way that you exit this particular problem of getting into panic and blame. Holding the money requires wealth-based thinking. That is the focus of real wealth. Rule 781, crypto technical analysis is a skill and a philosophy. Many people think that crypto technical analysis is simply drawing lines on charts. It is not. That is part of it, absolutely. But the philosophy of real wealth is a critical skill as well. Without the philosophy, people tend to fall back into Zone 1 and Zone 2 behavior. The philosophy of kindness, integrity, decency, honor, courage, fearlessness. These are the things that we focus on. As crypto technical analysts, it's really important to understand that there's both a skill aspect and a philosophy aspect. Let's have a look at what the markets are doing around the world. We always focus on the US market because the US market is the dominant market globally. Around $56 out of every $100 in stock markets is in the US market. It's a giant, and that's why we look at it. Let's have a look at the fear gauge, the VIX, of the stock market. We can see the fear is coming down, but we've had a bit of a spike up in the last session. What does this mean to price? Price is coming down. Where's it coming down to? It's coming down to test support. This is nothing more than natural price action. We see it all the time, these long spikes. What happens with retail thinking is any particular price momentum, either negative or positive, is viewed as it's going to the moon or it's going to zero. We simply, as professionals, look at this and say that's nothing more than natural price movement. It's striking a support level, so we would expect it to bounce, and we just keep our eye on it. Always making in advance probabilistic choices. What if it doesn't bounce? What if it goes sideways? And what if it comes up? These are critical things. You always want to get rid of your stress. What we also see is oil actually increasing dramatically in price. That's going to have inflationary effects. We can see bond prices doing a technical bounce after a massive sell-off. We can see bond yields doing a little bit of retrace because they've hit a particular resistance level. That's what always happens. When we hit technical resistance, we typically get pullbacks. And what are we seeing with gold? Gold did a technical bounce from support. It's up to a level of resistance here. It's just retracing. And what has the DXY done? The US dollar currency index. It's coming down to a level of support. What do we expect to see here? You got it, a technical bounce. There are two major issues that are affecting the world at the moment. Of course, there's always many, many more. But from a market terminology perspective, the C19 cases are just getting out of control. We can see that today, right now, we have 320.361 million, and we've had a massive spike up in the number of new infections. When we look at yesterday's data, we can see that 3.245 million cases were registered globally just yesterday. From an economic perspective, this means that stringency could be increased, but there's a kind of a stringency that's not being factored in here. It's just people going through so many different waves of C19. They're probably looking at it and saying, I don't really want to go out to the coffee shop and get my coffee. I'll just have it at home to avoid potential infection. We can see Germany has increased its stringency. What is stringency? It's about school closures, workplace closures, travel bans, those kind of things. Canada has been increasing. France had a bit of a leg up. India is now starting to increase. The US has not increased. The UK increased a little bit. These things are really important to understand from an economic perspective, because increased stringency will require stimulus. Masterclass students, when you get to TM3, you will get this particular chart. What is this? This is the transport indexes versus Bitcoin. Bitcoin is this yellow line here. What can we see about the airlines index? Even though the number of C19 cases are exponentially blowing out across the world, we can see the airlines are actually recovering. They've overcome a level of resistance and they're just starting to strike one up here. It's just a little bit more of a way to go, but this is quite good in terms of a recovery play. We can see other transport indexes coming up. We've had a bit of a wobble because the NASDAQ 100 suffered a bit of a loss, but this is all normal price action, creating higher lows each time. That is what price action does. It's always moving in a wave. Masterclass students, when you get up to TM4, you will get this live chart. Let's have a look at Bitcoin versus inflation expectations. We can see a very high degree of correlation has existed between inflation expectations and Bitcoin's price movement of late. What do we see around, for example, mid-November? Inflation expectations, 5-year inflation break-even rate and 10-year peaked around that period. And the central bank started talking about ratcheting up their anti-stimulus measures to pull money out of the system to combat inflation. But the potential problem here is that inflation is not realistically being caused just by excess money printing. Of course, it contributes. But the problem is C19, as you can see, is such a big problem. And people are staying away. They're staying home. And they're staying home without a lockdown. People are choosing to not participate in the economic system or do so from the safest level that they can. And of course, that does make sense. We've seen a divergence here between inflation expectations going up and Bitcoin coming down. This is nothing more than an institutional diversion. It means that the institutions are basically selling into this. They know structurally inflation is on the way up, and they know that the central banks are just doing a poker match. It's like a bluff. For example, if you have three aces in your hand and I'm bluffing that I've got four aces in my hand, you know that that's a bluff. It's the same way with an institutional mindset. You just look at what is actually happening in the charts, in the graphs, and the data, and you say, there's no way that they can do this. The other way that you can look at it is just like social engineering. Social engineering is when people ring up and say they're from the tech department and they need your username and password to reset something. They're just scammers. But the concept is social engineering is used all the time in the press, the media, and especially in government. Smart money institutional mindsets say you're bluffing, you're social engineering. I don't care what you're saying. Masterclass students, when you get to TM5, you will get my live chart of this. Let's have a look into the Chinese property market. We can see the Chinese property market between these different seven firms, from Evergrande to Fantasia to Scenic to Greenland, Country Garden, have net debt of over $1 trillion. There's a lot of talk about doom and gloom in the Chinese property market, but what do we see in terms of the share price? We can certainly see Vanke has actually recovered quite well in here. This is on the move up. We can see also that Evergrande, even from a long distance away, is improving. Let's just zoom in. So what we're looking at is a kick up in these particular measures. We're getting a little bit of a wobble around here. So the yellow is Country Garden. This blue one is Evergrande. What does this mean? To a retail investor, any negative price momentum means it's all over. Pack up, go home, sell everything. But we know rule four, price is always moving in a wave. This is just a natural part of price action. However, we do see Country Garden is breaking support under here. So there's potentially some news that will arise on Country Garden. Keep your eyes and ears open for that one. How do we sum this all up for Bitcoin's price action? We can see, of course, there are always negative things in the market. Bull markets climb a wall of worry is a really well-known phrase. There's never a point in time that everything is laid out on a red carpet. It just doesn't occur. Markets do not reward certainty. In fact, when things are most uncertain, that is the time when you want to lean in. Lean in does not mean go all in. It means buy at levels of support down, as low as you can possibly go, because price is negatively biased. But in conclusion, what do we see from the market? Everything is tracking quite well. Yes, there's an increase in fear, but that always happens, and that's happening all the time in financial markets. We look at gold and bond prices, bond yields. They're all acting really, really well. I don't see anything pointing to an imminent crash. And of course, the media says stock market will crash, bond market will crash, crypto will crash, gold will crash, silver will crash, dollar will crash. There's no shortage of crashes. And why do they do that? Because they want to sell. Our focus as crypto technical analysts is to cut through all the fluff and get to the heart of the issue. When we look at things, we can see certainly that there will be increased stimulus pressure going out into the future. There will be inflationary pressures. We also notice bond prices are not throwing any particular spanner in the works. things are looking fairly good for crypto. And of course, this channel, our community, is all about crypto. One of my favorite rules is rule 28, opportunities reset daily. This is just like in life. Yesterday is yesterday. Whatever happened in yesterday, done, dusted, bye-bye. Today, all the opportunities reset. The opportunity to be kinder, the opportunity to be stronger, the opportunity to pass the test that life throws at us every single day, to step up, to be more. It's a beautiful rule. I love rule 28. Let's have a look at the top eight. We can see Bitcoin starting to come out from a level of once resistance. It's crossed it a while back. Does this mean that Bitcoin can't come down? We know that it can come down. It can come down to around this level, around 37,692. That is possible. If you're in zone one and zone two or zone two, you might be panicking right now. Please don't do that. What we do as professionals, as smart money, we look at this and say, this is a fantastic opportunity to either lean in or hold. That is exactly what I'm doing. Many people are calling for the end of the world, but they've done that before and they've been wrong. For example, back here, when we had that massive sell-off, everybody was calling for 10,000 Bitcoin. I said, hold strong. At this particular level, I said the low has been set around $30,000, and that is pretty much where it bottomed out, and then it rallied 125% upwards. Please be aware, institutions play games with retail investors. Our focus is to get away from the retail mindset. The retail mindset is very, very destructive, and it's full of stress and loss, which is really the important thing you want to avoid. With that in mind, what we're basically saying is when Bitcoin turns around, and there could be one last hurrah, it's possible. When it does turn around, we will see all of the crypto market just coming up with Bitcoin. What you see in the background here, that blue line, that's Bitcoin's fingerprint, that's Bitcoin's price action. You can notice how the cryptos just follow Bitcoin. When crypto prices do diverge, like what we've seen in Luna, this can be because of many reasons. One reason is typically that the particular alt has a very, very solid story behind it. But please be aware that Bitcoin's gravity is absolute. Bitcoin's gravity will pull the alts back into its direction. It happens all the time. It's really important to be aware of. So what we can see is Bitcoin could come down a little bit more. It's still under a level of resistance, and we know that. So the entire crypto market is under a level of resistance. We're just making our three-way probabilistic choices. We can see Ethereum is under resistance. Binance coin is bouncing from support. This is really quite powerful price action. Please bear this in mind. That's a good crypto Binance coin. When we see Solana, it's a little bit under resistance. We're just trying to figure out if this is a retest to push down or it's getting above that particular level. We can see Cardano still under resistance. XRP is changing from this resistance to support. We can see DOT as well, just seeking to consolidate, and Luna doing really, really well. Always bear in mind, there are massive price spikes and volatility in these kind of performing cryptos. It's the same with every crypto really, but some are more so than others. That's why you don't need to use gearing. You can just buy at spot, which means you swap your, for example, USD or USDT or USDC or BNB or whatever it is, for a particular crypto. And then you hold that crypto independently of the particular token or coin that you swapped it with in the original place. So if you've got Luna and you bought it through, for example, BNB, now you can swap Luna to Bitcoin if you wanted, or swap it to a fiat currency. But please bear in mind, when you're swapping in and out, when you're taking profits, please try to book it into a stable coin. So let's have a look at Doge. Doge is getting, well, it's doing quite well. You can see it's done a technical bounce from its support level and it's continuing to go up. It's showing more strength than SHIB that rejected this resistance line. AVAX is coming back to a resistance line. Matic is looking fantastic. It's not looking problematic at all. Matic in the past is sort of a wobbler. It can do really well sometimes, and other times it wobbles around a bit. So we'll keep our eye on Matic. We can see Litecoin is seeking to recover this particular resistance level. Uni is under resistance. Chainlink has been doing really, really well. It's just forming a pattern of higher lows. It looks actually quite good from a technical perspective. We also know that Chainlink and Bitcoin are very highly positively correlated, especially from a directional movement. So please bear that in mind. Let's have a look at Algo. Algo is just consolidating at a level of support. Looking at the next date, we can see Bitcoin Cash seriously under resistance. Tron is looking quite fascinating. When we look at Tron, it's following Bitcoin's fingerprint, basically to a ping. This could be really fascinating. When Bitcoin starts to make its way up, I think Tron could do very well. Just something to bear in mind. Let's have a look at Decentraland. Decentraland on its way down, just under this particular resistance line. But what do we understand? This is following Bitcoin's fingerprint. It's the same with all of them. Axie Infinity doing likewise. Look at Stellar. Stellar is doing exactly the same. It's following Bitcoin's fingerprint. So if anybody says, what happened to my alt? You can say, Bitcoin happened to your alt. It's not very comforting, is it? But it's kind of the way it goes. We can see Cosmos, Atom. It has a level of divergence in the price action here. You can see Bitcoin's gravity is out of alignment with Atom. This could be problematic to Atom as the general market turns around. It's also what I call a changing of the guards. Please be aware of this. It doesn't mean that Cosmos is coming down. It does mean that we have to be careful of it, because always gravity and the gravitational pull will align at some stage. FTT or FTX token is just consolidating around a level of support. It doesn't look too bad. Looking at the next date, we can see EGLD just consolidating around this particular area. It's under resistance, so we need to keep that in mind, but it's following Bitcoin's gravitational pull. And this is quite important. When Bitcoin repairs, when it gets better, when it comes out of its particular pullback, we can see that this will rally. The entire crypto market will rally. We can also see ICP has been under resistance for quite a while and has, I'll just zoom in there a little bit, it's coming back to test that once resistance line, trying to turn it to support, and it's getting pushed back. There's a lot of sellers on this. We need to be aware of these kind of charts. We can see Sand is just following Bitcoin's fingerprint at the moment. Gravitations have aligned. This will be really interesting when Bitcoin's price starts to improve. We're going to see some really interesting stuff with Sand. We can also see Filecoin is under resistance. CHR is coming back to a level of support at around 72.30. We can see Theta is still under resistance. It tried to get above, but it wasn't successful. Let's have a look at Ethereum Classic, still heavily under resistance, showing a lot of weakness. In comparison, NEAR is going really far, near and far, wherever you are, you're doing really well. And our hearts will go on. Sorry, can't resist. When we look at NEAR, this is a really, really strong crypto. Please be aware that when the market that's been coming down for about 60 to 63 days starts to actually get healthy, people will start booking profits from the particular cryptos that did really well when the market was coming down. This is what I call changing of the guards. Please be aware. Does it mean that you should sell? Not necessarily. It's all about understanding the risks and just using a probability-based approach to look at things and say, okay, I've pretty much made a good profit on that. Looking at the community favorites, we can see Veracity tested its resistance line and was rejected, but it's following Bitcoin's fingerprint. So when Bitcoin starts to go up, we can expect exactly what, or we'll know what VRA is going to do. Icon, just following Bitcoin's fingerprint as well. It's a little bit weaker than VRA. Let's have a look at Sushi. Sushi is still under resistance. I'm just thinking of the meme that Let Me Know Barry put out on Twitter. Very good. IOTA. We can see IOTA is just following the directional movement of Bitcoin. And this is really perplexing for many people because they look at a project and say, because of this project, I know what's happening. But the wider crypto market is the thing that you need to also look at. Look at KSM, just following Bitcoin's fingerprint really, really well. Don't forget, the fingerprint is the directional bias of particular movement, both up and down. KSM could do really well when it starts to repair. And we can see that there could be very significant gains in KSM over time. RSR, reserve rights. We can see RSR is still under multiple levels of resistance, but this doesn't really worry us that much because we know that the entire crypto market is tied to Bitcoin's future. Really nice to know that. Audio, we can see audio actually has strength here. It found that support line and it bounced technically. It's coming down because Bitcoin is coming down. Let's have a look at CTSI. Cartesi is seeking to party. It's really interesting to note that just zooming in there, Cartesi went up 48.96% in 3 days. It's having a pullback at the moment. Why is that? Because Bitcoin is pulling back. As a community, we don't engage in zone one and zone two behavior. No aggression and no blaming and no FUD or FOMO. We simply look at something like Cartesi and say, Cartesi, you're very spiky. You go up and down a lot. So I'm going to be layering in at lower levels if you're interested. I think it's really nice to go through the comments on YouTube. We have an absolutely incredible community, just full of wonderful, wonderful people. I'd just like to share a couple of quotes from them. Cindy, Rocky and I are recovering slowly and going to be able to leave isolation on the weekend. How fantastic, Cindy and Rocky. That's just beautiful news. Learning so much from the masterclass. The penny is starting to drop. We have such a beautiful community. And I believe the real wealth advice is what separates us from just about everybody else. When I was studying finance, doing my finance degree, there was no concept at all about real wealth. There was just the Gordon Gekko kind of idea that you needed to own the world. And it was very somehow empty and unsatisfying because when you do really, really well financially, if there is no meaning, it's simply another form of poverty. It's a form of emptiness. That's why crypto technical analysis could actually change many, many things in finance. Because we're focused on not just the skill, but the philosophy as well. Thank you very much to Richard. You scored 100% in your very unique TA reading of the crypto and the broader market. Thanks so much, Richard. Richard is an incredibly talented person. He's been in finance for many, many decades. Thank you, my friend. It's really nice of you. Thank you, Gabscar, our dedication to the community. And the meditative mind, is the Fed all smoke and mirrors? Yes. Is the trickle effect on raising rates mammoth due to the increased debt servicing and borrowing? Absolutely, my friend. Very, very true. Crypto Turtle, for the people who are not in the masterclass, whatever you see in the daily channel, you will see 10 times more inside the class. It's absolutely correct. Inside the masterclass, I have the ability to transfer to you my 30 plus years in financial markets. Very nice, Crypto Turtle. No one is matching the masterclass, especially in the real wealth section. I think this is so incredibly important. Many people just think about going after money. And of course, if you don't have a lot, that is what you want to do. And whoever has enough in many respects. The problem is that when we don't focus on real wealth, all the money that you make will leave things empty inside. The issue is it doesn't create meaning. And one of the things that Crypto Turtle talked about, I've seen the courses out there. The courses on crypto technical analysis are mainly from people in the Forex market and the stock market. And unfortunately, they use a very outdated and obsolete method of looking at, for example, candlestick patterns and a lot of other indicators. We do something completely different in the Crypto Trading KS Masterclass. I've actually updated hundreds and hundreds of years of candlestick analysis theory and created a completely new method which you can actually analyze. But it takes a lot of dedication and commitment to learn. And that's why people talk about the penny dropping. You don't get 30 years of experience just overnight in one or two video lessons. It just doesn't work that way. It's all about being practical. And thank you very much to the king of memes. Let me know, Barry. I can't wait to apply what I've learned in your masterclass thus far in the upcoming year. Very, very nice comments. Leslie, hello, Ken. The masterclass is just extraordinary. Content is just brimming over with knowledge gems. Thank you, Leslie. Very nice of you to say. I want to also say thank you to Vicente. Vicente, every day you bring us new fundamental concepts that by ourselves would take years to perceive. That's what I really love about sharing my knowledge. There's a lot of knowledge there to share, and I'm really, really happy to do so. I'm glad it's helping. And thank you very much for your very kind comment. And Benny, kindness opens many doors. Absolutely. And if we go the other way and think of what aggression and conflict do, aggression and conflict always slam the door in somebody else's face or our own face, be that as it may. Coming from a finance and law background, I've spent a lot of time in the legal area, and that is just pure conflict. As a senior executive, I knew nothing but conflict, and I know that it's not the way. Being kind is really important, and understanding is also important. But that doesn't mean that we're doormats. That doesn't mean that we don't stand up and say our mind and speak our truth. Absolutely we do, but we do it with respect, and that's important. There are so many beautiful comments that I would love to read out. If you would like to go to the comments section on YouTube, you can have a look at the incredible community we have. And we are a definite community. We're like an extended family. Everybody's really respectful of each other. And I want to reach out to the community and say, I've never met a group of more loving and kind people. It's just an honor to know you. I would also like to thank Ted for his really, really great work. As you can see, we're on target for that 486 blow off. If you would like to have a look at the masterclass, the link is in the description of this video. The whole focus is that I want to enable you to do what I do by transferring my knowledge to you so that you can be more of a financial blessing to yourself and those you love. I hope you found the content useful. Please consider sharing and liking this video if you think it will help others. Thank you very much to our moderators for keeping our community safe from scammers. Please say hi and let me know if you have any questions. If you would like daily updates on price movements in the crypto market, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, please subscribe to YouTube. I've left helpful links in the description of this video as well. Please remember, crypto is volatile. Always prepare yourself for the best and worst case scenarios. Reality will likely be between them. Stay safe out there, my friends. Take care and see you next time. Bye for now.